This is the SAP Developer News for July the 17th, 2025.
Big news this week, Joule Studio was released. Joule Studio is the new tool within SAP Build that lets you create your own custom skills for Joule. In other words, you can define what prompts Joule responds to and also define the messages and data to display in response to those prompts. Michael Ameling, president of BTP, announced the release in his blog. Maria Kontrantieva, a product manager, also wrote a blog about the details of the commercial model and what landscapes you can install Joule Studio on. Here she is in an exclusive interview with Developer News, describing some of the capabilities.
So you can start building your own custom Joule skills by bringing any application or any data source or any system transactions to your Joule.
In addition, a set of learning materials were released so you can start creating Joule skills. First, there was a product tour click-through where you can see the UI and some of the key capabilities. A video was released showing you step-by-step how to create your first skill. And a set of very detailed tutorials were released within the developer tutorial area that shows you how to create skills, including several different skills, so you can see how to use processes and actions within your skills. Michael, Maria, and Miguel Meta Martinez, another product manager, also described how agents will soon be added to the things that you can create within Joule Studio. Here's Miguel talking about those plans.
Hi, everyone. I'm thrilled to announce that Joule Studio Skill Builder is now generally available. You can finally make Joule your Joule. But this is just the beginning. Please stay tuned for AI agent capabilities coming to Joule Studio later this year.
I will leave links to the videos, to the blogs, to the click-through tour, and to the tutorials in the description.
The third quarterly release of SAP Analytics Cloud is a month away, but the product team has already shared a sneak peek into the top 5 features of QRC 3 2025. We have a very special AI-focused release coming your way this quarter with AI-assisted advanced formula generation, AI-assisted chart summary, AI-assisted commenting.
Say AI again. I dare you. I double dare you.
Okay. Let me talk about dashboard design best practices then. As a part of this series of blog posts, the new one has been published and it is focused on template types, layout settings, theming, and so on. Links are in the description.
Hi everyone, and welcome to the SAP Developer News. The UI5 team just recently published the legacy-free version of SAP UI5 and OpenUI5, which you can now test and check out. They removed all the deprecated code and APIs, and it includes the modular bootstrap, for example, which increases performance, and it's now ready for you to test out. Do not use it in production, rather use it in development to make sure your UI5 apps are future-proof. Check out the link in the description for more information, and hope to talk to you soon. Bye.
Hola, SAP developers. So it's been an eventful week. We've been running quite a few code gems this week, all focusing on SAP Integration Suite, right? So we've been running code gems. I started in Madrid and then in Abu Dhabi. And then, well, now we are here in India, but all code gems actually took place in India. So tell us a bit more about the code gems in India.
Yeah. So we had quite a lot of code gem we already did starting on Monday, where we had our first code jam in Colgate in Mumbai. And then it was followed by the second code jam that we had in Hyderabad. So we flew to Hyderabad and we had the second code jam related to advanced event mesh at Hyderabad Mindset. And yesterday we had it in Infosys campus. And again, it was the advanced event mesh integration suite code jam that we ran there. And today we are here in SAP Bangalore, SAP Labs Bangalore doing event-driven processes in SAP Build Process Automation. And tomorrow we are going to PointSet and we will do a code jam there, connecting systems and services using integration suite. So what else, Antonio?
Well, it's a pretty packed week, I would say. So yeah, just remember that you can obviously request code jams via the SAP community website. Just visit the SAP code jam group and all the details there and all the different topics that we do as code jams are also listed there. So do check it out. And remember, code jams are a great, easy way to get familiar with different SAP BTP technologies. So looking forward to meeting you in a future code jam.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye.
Hey folks, Rich Hallman here. I hope everyone is doing well. I just wanted to pop on here and let you all know that the session catalog is now live for SAP TechEd 2025 in Berlin. The teams are working really hard to bring back the magic of TechEds of the past, and that includes great content from our SAP experts. From the catalog, you can filter down the sessions by track, session type, session experience level, and others. You can browse deep dive sessions, hands-on workshops, roadmaps, and strategy talks, and click to add them to your favorites. This is also the same place where you'll be able to reserve your seats for hands-on workshops when that piece goes live. We are all really excited to get everyone back together and bring everyone home in Berlin. So check out the session catalog, see what we have to offer this year, and register today, and we'll see you in Berlin. Bye for now.
In this new segment, I'd like to talk to you about the Application Front-End Service. It's a relatively new service offering in SAP BTP. It's only been available for a couple of months. It is a service that is designed to help you with the building, the deployment, and the managing of the front-end portions of your application. So it can help you deploy your SAP UI5 Fiori applications in conjunction with ABAP or CAP backends. Now, it's very similar to the functionality provided by both the application router and, if you've ever used it, the HTML5 repository in the old Neo environment. In fact, it wants to deliver many of the same features and capabilities, but do so in a centralized managed service. So you're not having to deal with the infrastructure deployment of each application that you want to host a front end for. It has both command line and tooling integrated into the development environment, such as Baz or a web-based console to help you with deploying your applications. You can also deploy it as part of a MTA, a multi-target application. But the best news probably is that it is now available as part of the SAP BTP trial. So if you're curious about the application front-end service, try it out today for free in the BTP trial.
The latest Q2 2025 update for SAP BTP is now available, bringing exciting improvements across development, integration, analytics, and more. Some key highlights include application development and automation, which enhances tools for faster app building in the Cloud Foundry environment. Integration services, which updates to SAP's connectivity authorization and trust management, and the audit log service. Analytics and data management, with new services and expanded support in data handling. This release continues SAP's BTP mission to unify database, AI, analytics, development automation, and integration seamlessly. Straight from SAP's SE's 2012 foundation to today's cloud-native powerhouse. If you're building on BTP, these updates are designed to make your work smoother, smarter, and faster. You can read more in the description.